day, Royals fans. This is the latest edition of the Royal Take as we're previewing our Reading Royals against the Newfoundland Growlers as they take on the team right on their tail in the division in second place. As a big game today, as our Reading Royals look to keep their positive play going, as they look to take down the Newfoundland Growlers today at 5:30 p.m. and then followed by another 5:30 p.m. game on Friday and Saturday at 5:30 p.m. I doubt there's a lot of times in a row there's been three straight at 5:30, but that's how it is this week for our Reading Royals. After obviously in the most recent tilts, last game out we lost to Maine, but we destroyed Adirondack 5-2 prior to that on Friday, January 28th, and then also beat Trois-Rivières on the 22nd after losing them on the 23rd, and then destroyed Adirondack 5-2 again. That we did that twice in a very short stretch from 21 of January to the 28th of January. So the Reading Royals are taking care of business. They're just have mixed in a few losses here and there, but we're still the first place team. That's what you're going to do. All great teams. That's hockey. That's sports. You're not going to win them all. But what I love about this team, I've said it 90 times already, I think, this season when it comes to my Royal takes, but the perseverance and the bounce back that this team always has. If they lose a game, they're probably going to come back and win the next game. And they did lose the last game against the Maine Mariners. Danny Breyer's Maine Mariners. Alex Kyle from the Maine Mariners is doing absolutely fantastic for the Lehigh Valley Phantoms, for my three-way fans between the Royals fans and Flyers, or the two-way of the two minor league teams. He's doing fantastic for them. But when it comes to the Royals, the key for beating this team is similar to how they beat other teams this year, like Worcester and other teams that they played, is jamming them in the neutral zone. This team and the Newfoundland Growlers, when we take a look at them to look at their stats, they've allowed under 80 goals this year at 79. They're a good defensive team. And they also have punch in star power led by Gordy Green, Marcus Power, no pun intended, Santanzo, Oren Santanzo, and the best of the bunch, Zach O'Brien, who has 31 points on the season and, excuse me, is one of the best players in the entire league. Zach O'Brien really knows how to get it done. Nathan Knoll brings toughness to that group as well. So this team overall just has pack-a-punch star power. They also have Kapchick, Pietraniero, and others, Pomerlo, and others on defense. That man, that top-notch defense for the Newfoundland Growlers to round out their team. When it comes to our Reading Royals, oh, and for the Growlers, I should also say the goals for them, they allowed 79 goals against 101 goals for, and they're very solid on the penalty kill, 91 penalty kills and 110 chances, 29 power play goals, though, 118 chances, so not as good on the power play. Now let's move into a the Reading Royals, as we move into our first place, Reading Royals and their numbers, as we have 105 goals, but 96 goals allowed. The Reading Royals have not been that good on the power play either. As we know, we've had some better success of late, though. 23 for 106, 72 penalty kills, though, 93 opportunities. And when it comes to when we do the player or the team comparison, 105 goals, 4-101. The power play percentages is in favor of Newfoundland, 25%. The penalty kill is also in favor of Newfoundland, 83% to 77% for Reading. I would like to see that power play keep, or penalty kill, keep ticking up towards the 80 percentile and try to get above that again. And that would be great for the special teams. And then obviously the penalty, or the power play, I would like to see just get towards the 25 percentile and then get up from there. But when it comes to our Reading Royals, the Reading Royals are, of course, led by the great all-star season of Jacob Pritchard. Patrick Bykoff has got hot again. Braden Lowe has always been fantastic. Brad Morrison has come in and done fantastic for this team. He has 18 points. When he first got here, it took him a little bit to get going, but you could see the offense he provided and the offensive skill set and hands he had, and then he really started getting going in bunches. Gagnon has been a huge addition. So the big thing about this Royals team is they've been really getting scoring throughout, as when you look at this team, you have so many guys in the teens in points, all the way down to Kenny Holzinger, where Cooper Winquist, who would be well above the teens in points if he never got injured. Cam Strong, who's played very good as a rookie and has 9 points in 19 games. And then Grant Cooper, who's played solid as well, 7 points. Everybody else in the forward core, minus three people, are in the teens in points. So it shows you got depth scoring. With Patrick McNally, he's obviously provides a lot of points. Dominic Cormier, Garrett Cicery. You have three guys above 10 points with the defense. And then you have very good overall play just in general with the Brands, Cockrells, and McFadden's of the world. So the Reading Royals, I think this team is poised to battle to the end and battle to the bloodbath death with the Newfoundland Growlers for this division. And that is who they're facing today. It's going to be between Newfoundland, Trois-Rivières, and Reading, I think, to the end for this division. The Reading Royals face the Newfoundland Growlers at 5:30, trying to get going back after losing 2-1 to the Maine Mariners. Last time out, as today, the Keys are going to be jamming this team at the neutral zone and also trying to get a early goal through one of the best defenses in the league, in the Newfoundland Growlers. Defense there, and that's going to be a key for the Reading Royals. Success today, they also got Petruzzelli and Evan Cormier in net, both successful netminders, so you have to watch out for their netminders, as of course the Reading Royals have Hayden Hawkey and Kirill Ustamenko, also guys that have been very successful in net at different times this season for the Reading Royals. This has been a preview to the Reading Royals and Newfoundland Growlers, the first-place team against the second-place team. That's always a very good matchup. Hope everyone enjoyed this video. Please continue to subscribe down below or above on the easy-to-use widget. Peace out, everybody. Stay safe and enjoy the game.